Good morning, students. See, in the last lecture, we have discussed about the physical properties of metal. Okay, so what are metals and non-metals and how to identify it? And some notes also I have given you already in the last lecture. See, these metals and non-metals we are classified as for their physical properties and chemical properties. Okay, but now in the 6th standard we have to learn only the physical properties of metals and non-metals. So see, the physical properties of metals, these already we have discussed in the before lecture, that is the lustrous. Lustrous means what? The metals, means those are metals, they show a shine on that particular substance. So we can easily identify it is a metal. Now see here, this what it is, a plastic material. Okay, this bench is made up of wood. So these so many things are made of a different substances. So now which are the metals that we have to identify with the help of the physical properties of that? Okay, so the first physical property, it is a lustrous. Lustrous means what? It has a shine. Mostly all the metals has a shine. Then hardness. All the metals, mostly metals are hard, and some exceptions I have told you before also, the sodium. Okay, sodium is a metal, but it is an exceptional because it is a soft metal that we can easily cut with a knife. Then see, ductility, physical state, malleability, conduction of heat and conduction of electricity. So these 7 properties, these 7 physical properties that we have learned before also. Okay, if you have any doubt regarding these properties, please you can ask me. Now the next physical property that we will see, that is a density. Now see, this density term maybe you have learned in the physics. Okay, now density, those are the metals, mostly they are having a high density. Okay, now density means what? Mass upon volume. Okay, density means what? Mass upon volume. So density, the mostly metals have a more density. For example, suppose in front of you, you take one glass, okay, and take the two objects, means one is a plastic material in the object and one is a, you take iron object. Okay, now so these two objects, see here, this pen cap I have taken, this is a plastic, and one you take a iron object, iron nail. Okay, and these two substance you dip inside the water. Which one will sink in the water? You only tell me, iron. Why? Because iron has a more, it is a more dense than this a plastic cap. Okay, so mostly all the metals, they are having a high density. Okay, and you have learned this in detail in physics. So now the next point, see, a melting point and boiling point. Okay, now metals, melting point and boiling point. Now melting point means what? See, when any substance start a melting, okay, means now in this a normal temperature, suppose it is in a solid substance, when it start melting means what? Solid to a liquid. Melting means what? When it convert into a liquid state, that is only the melting. So that particular point is known as a melting a point. Okay, now iron. Iron is one metal, gold is metal, silver is metal. Okay, now these the substances, these metals having different melting points, means at different melting points they start a melting. Now iron, it is very hard, okay, and it is more dense also, and it is also more. Okay, so when you will give the heat to that iron object at a high temperature, it start a melting, and that temperature is known as a melting point of a iron object. Okay, I'm just giving you the example of one iron object. So mostly different metals having different melting point, high melting point and boiling point. So all the metals, they are having high melting point as well as the boiling point. Now boiling point means what? When it start boil. Now water, you know what is the boiling point of water? 100 degrees Celsius. Means at a 100 degree Celsius temperature, water start boil. So that is known as a boiling point of water. Okay. Now the last property is of sonority. See what you understood about this melting and boiling point means mostly the metals, they are having a high melting point and boiling point. Now the last property is known as a sonority. Now sonority means what? See, do you heard the bell? See, when our period finished, now you are at home, but when you will be here in the school. So that time, how we know that now this period is finished, now next lecture will be for this maths, for this ABS, or science. How we know that? Because the bell ring. Okay. So how the bell produce sound? How the bell produce sound? Means, see, behind that, it's open, the reason is there. Suppose that bell, it is, now see your picture, it is shown, it is made of the wooden material. Then it will produce a sound. You just think that it will produce sound? No. So that bell is made of a metal. And metal shows this property of sonority. Sonority means what? Metal produce sound. And that property is known as a sonority. Understood? Sonority means what? Mostly all the metals produce sound, and that property is known as a sonority. You take spoon and glass, and in another, you just take a wooden end material and just heat it. Which one will produce sound? Spoon, which is made of metals. Okay, it will produce a sound. Simple activity you can do at home also. So sonority means what? Metals are produce sound. This property is the sonority property. Understood? So metal shows this different properties, that is the luster, hardness, ductility, physical state, malleability, conduction of heat, conduction of electricity, density, melting and boiling point, and sonority. See, in the 6th standard, we just have to look what are the physical properties and how to identify the metals and non-metals with the help of their various physical properties. In 8th standard, we are going to learn in a detail these all again, and in chemical properties also. So, today, with these physical properties of metals, this part is a completed. See, I have given you notes, just go through that notes, read each and every point, and which are the metals and what are the symbols of metals, just to see it, write down in your chemistry notebook. Okay, now I told last time that one experiment we are going to conduct here, which shows the metal conduct heat. Okay, the metal conduct heat, which shows the metal conduct heat. That experiment definitely we will do in our next video. Okay? So today we will stop here. You have any doubt related to this, then you can ask me. So tomorrow we will continue our next point, that is the physical properties of non-metals. Thank you.